every couple days, every week, couple weeks, you know, someone's arrested, someone's sentenced, and the law is passed.
I can't trust the government and the police.
Hong Kong still has its own currency. It's considered a separate customs territory. It has its own membership in many international organizations. You are part of China. You are not independent, but you have such a high degree of autonomy that you are actually operating a separate legal system.
Free expressions and freedom of assembly have been drastically diminished.
Under the new law, when in Hong Kong, I can't say anything. What I see, what happened in Hong Kong, they lost the freedom of speech.
People will feel under a kind of surveillance by their neighbors, by their workmates.
Fight for freedom!
I think there's a lot of fear in society now, a lot of uncertainty of what you can say and what you can do.
You have to be a patriot to serve in Hong Kong's government. You promise not to be at all confrontational with the Chinese Communist Party. The whole purpose of it is to ensure that the executive branch, which is still appointed by Beijing, will now have a very docile and supportive legislative council. From the perspective of some people in Hong Kong, this is just bringing Hong Kong back to the way it functioned in the pure colonial period. It's just that the executive branch is being appointed by Beijing instead of London.
We are sad to leave our home, Hong Kong. This is a new life, a new place. We need to face the future.
There's an overwhelming feeling of loss right now, but Hong Kongers have always been very, very creative. I think people are pouring their hearts into a lot of the work that they're doing about Hong Kong. I think that's something to look towards.